Hello, it's Mr. Sorbas here. Before I start the review, I think I have to tell a very short story of why I am doing this video. Feel free to skip this part with the link in the pinned comment if you feel so. Now, I think Mesh Machine is a very good Blender add-on, but that's not the only reason, because I already did a video about it roughly 2 years ago. But I said something in the description of that video. I am going to redo this video after a few weeks. There have been so many new things added to the add-on that it will be unfair to leave it like this. 2 years and I didn't do what I promised. However, I also didn't forget it. In fact, it's quite hard for me to forget that kind of things. 2 years and I have been thinking of this video almost monthly. Isn't that crazy? Same thing happened to me when my friend borrowed me money so that I could buy a computer. So I bought the computer, and after that I was thinking that roughly 800 euros debt for very much. I was slowly paying it back, but to be honest, I never was rich enough to be able to pay it back right away. At least that's how I felt. So, every time I bought anything not so much important, I was thinking that I am cheating him somehow because I didn't send that money to him instead. He was a developer and I was just a very cheap graphical designer, so it took years to pay it back and sometimes it came to my sleep. At least now I'm free of the debt and it felt so good when I paid last bits of it. This video is to me a similar thing. It's way more than a few weeks, so it's clear that I failed this promise. But I still have to do this because I think it's better late than never. That's also why I'm usually trying to not promise anything, but instead say something like, I will look if I can do it. This time I, however, promised, but I didn't do it. Now I will do it. So, you can install the Mesh Machine here in Edit and then Preferences, and then you have here this Install button and you click it and find the Mesh Machine from your computer. And after you did that, you have here this Mesh Machine settings thing, which allows you to change some of the shortcuts of the add-on and so on. So, for example, in Edit mode, the default shortcut is Y, and then in object mode it as well is Y. So those are good to remember. And then I activated here this in edit mode and in object mode the display for the context menu. So let's save user preferences here and then close this whole thing. And now if you right click with the Blender default settings, you will open the object context menu. And now you have here in the top this Mesh Machine menu. But if you don't have the default settings for default shortcuts for Blender and you are using the old shortcuts, then you should click W. But I'm not going to use those and I'm not going to explain those anymore. It's very easy to learn the new shortcuts. You just need to do something with Blender and force yourself to use left click. Now let's look a little bit about the anatomy of a beveled corner in Blender. So if I press Ctrl plus B and then create only this kind of very flat bevel, it's going to be called in the Mesh Machine a chamfer. And if I use mouse wheel like this, then I will create a fuse. So let's create first a chamfer like that, and then I can now press Y to open the Mesh Machine, or right click and use the Mesh Machine menu here. I'm gonna use here this my Y. So if I now select here the fuse, I can make this to be a fuse like that. And I have here this hovering list of settings which I can activate. I can use mouse wheel to add more of those segments like that. And then I have here those toggle settings, but I don't like using those. I don't find this to be very useful in my opinion. Instead, I will press left click, and then I have all of those settings here in this kind of menu that is, in my opinion, easier to use. So I can change the amount of segments with this, and then I can change the tension of this thing with this, and I can use also these presets very easily like that. I can also add here the caps or remove those like that. In fact, it should not. Oh yeah, so and then you have here this, because I didn't activate this cap, it's not going to create that here, but I can make it to be separated from the Angon with that dissolve angle setting. So now if I wanna unfuse this, I wanna make this to be a chamfer again. So I go here in face selection mode and then I select all of those and then I press Y and then I here select this unfuse. And it will create it to be a chamfer like that. But there is a trick, if you select too much, let's say you had all of those selected like this, and now if you select the unfuse, it's not going to work, the selection is illegal, so don't do that, only select those. This likes to select always this edge selection mode, but yeah, select those, and then now unfuse, and then it's going to work like that. So remember that there's this kind of selection trick. If you selection tricks, if you select wrong things, then the add-on is not going to work. But now I have here this my chamfer, and if I wanna get rid of this chamfer, I can here select this unfuse like that, and it's going to be now back the original cube. Or I can window everything back, and now I have here this my bevel, and I can make all of those steps at once. I can select Y and then unbevel, and it will get rid of that fused bevel and then the chamfer as well, like that. Okay, then we have the tool which is created to fix this kind of problem. So if you created the bevel here like that, and then you end up having this kind of distortion effect term, you can fix it with the tool called. And now if you select this, you can kind of fix the edges like that, and you can select those and then again use the same tool like that and so on. So by that way you can very fast fix the distortion problems in your bevels. It's okay if it didn't become perfect, because now when you have done all of those steps, you can now select this kind of area and then you can now use refuse. And that will create it to be very smooth and beautiful. And then you can, of course, or whatever you like to do with it. Then we have another tool which is called flatten. And I will show you now very fast how you can use those. So let's create here that first something that we can work with. I don't know, I have no idea what I'm doing here, but let's say something like that. So now you have an idea that this has to be a flat surface. So you select those both and then here mesh machine and select the flatten. And as you can see, it works just fine. And there is two methods, along edge or along normals. Allows you to create very nice objects very fast. Alright, then sometimes you have this kind of problem. So you create a bevel like this and then you will end up having here this triangle. So you can fix that with mesh machine. So you select that triangle and then with mesh machine menu you select here quad corner, and that will create for you this kind of corner. And then what you can do now is that you can actually rotate this or quad face, turn corner like this, and by that way you will now make the edge flow to go in other direction. So like that, you see that it's going now to this direction, but before it was going to that direction. So this is very handy sometimes when you are working with, even when you are not working with hard surface objects, you can be creating, let's say, a human face red topology, and you have a very bad topology problem and you wanna fix it. So that allows you to do it. Okay, the next tool is called Boolean Cleanup. So let's first create something to be used with the Boolean. So something like that, and then let's add here something to create a hole to this object. So I'm gonna create here a cylinder and something like that. And now select the sphere and select the boolean generate, and the operation is going to be difference, and then the object is obviously going to be this cylinder. Now I can apply this and delete this cylinder. So now if I select this, I can select first this my bottom part here, and then control plus I will select this whole area and then deselect this my bottom part of this hole, so that I have only this edge selected, and I have to be here in vertex selection mode. And then I will go here to mesh machine and select boolean clean up. So as you can see, I can now control this whole thing with this mouse movement like that. So as you can see, there is first those red things which are being merged to those green things like that, and then I can control this whole operation by that way also. So the A is this outer area, and then B is this inner area. So if I wanna merge those inner vertices, then I will select this B operation. So yeah, that basically is the boolean cleanup. Okay, so now you have this kind of boolean hole there, but you also wanna have a bevel around this hole. So if you use Blender bevel tool, Ctrl plus B, you are going to make a mess. So let's not do that. Instead, let's call the mesh machine menu and let's use here this chamfer tool. So as you can see, it already looks much better than what Blender did with the default tools. And now you can here go and select this merge. And by that way, you kind of created the bevel look quite beautiful. And there's another tool you can also use here, this replace method, and then use this reach. And it depends very much on which looks better and where you have less steps needed to make it look perfect. So you might need to do some manual tweaking with this, but just check both of those and see which one looks better. And now again, you can use the fuse tool to kind of finalize this bevel. So use that one and then select the to create the effect you are happy with. Now the thing in Mesh Machine which we didn't have when I did my first video about this add-on is called plugs. So how to use plugs? You need to have your target object. In my case, I have this beveled cube. So first I need to relocate the 3D cursor. And now when I have the 3D cursor here, I can press Y and I can now find the plug in libraries. And if I click here this plus, it's going to select this object, but instead I wanna select something else from this list. So let's add here something like, I don't know, maybe this for example. So I will double click that, and now I have this object here, and I can scale it with Escape just like I can scale any object in Blender. And then I can move it around with G key, and if I hold Ctrl when I'm moving it, then it's kind of snapping to the surface of this object. So you always should hover Ctrl when you are moving your plugs. You see how it's now here. But I will first add it in this flat surface like that. And now when I found the good location for my plug, I can shift select both of those objects, and then I can now open the mesh machine menu and here select plug. So that's it. Now it's plugged into this object perfectly and it looks just fine. And I can here go to make it look even better by going in these object data properties and select normals and then auto smooth. So that will fix it. And then I can of course set this whole thing smooth. Okay, so what about those curved surfaces? So let's locate the 3D cursor here and then Y and then plug in back libraries and then open something else that looks cool. So for example, this looks quite complex and nice, so I will select it again with G, and then holding control I can move it around to a place where I think it would be good. Actually, I wanna make this to be, I don't know why, but I wanna make this quite big, and then we can see how it works, if it works at all. So something like that, and then shift select the target object, and then Y, and then plug. And as you can see, it looks quite nice. It's not perfect because it was so big. Let's undo that maybe, and let's maybe add here some additional segments so the surface is a little bit more detailed. So control plus R, let's add here something like that. And now I will select this object, and again Y, and then plug. Let's see if it, I think it looks now much better because I added those additional edges like that. So very easy and very nice and very fun. So let's keep adding more of those Y, and then libraries, and then I don't know, maybe this one. Okay, I don't know, this is very much experimental. I just had this very stupid idea to add two of these things. So if I now select this one, and then this one, and then Y, and then plug, it's working. And then I select this one, and this one, and again I select plug, and it's working. And the topology looks like this. And of course this is still separated object, at least part of this is separated. Little bit of those shading problems, so I can use for example knife tool and then try to cut here, and then knife tool again and cut here. So it most definitely works better on little bit higher resolution surfaces than these very low poly surfaces. For example here I can try for example cut here and here. Okay, so that kind of little additional fine tuning can make your thing much better. As you can see, it always makes it look a little bit better when I do that. Alright, so let's test to create our own plug now with Mesh Machine. So Shift plus A, let's add here a plane. And why plane? Because the plane represents the surface of the target object, so it's always good idea to start from a plane, and it's going to make sure that the plug works. So start from a plane, and then let's press I to insert, and I'm just gonna extrude here some depth. So this is going to be a very simple plug, just to test that it works, and it's based on the tutorial, their own tutorial. So if you wanna have a little bit more depth understanding of how these plugs works and what are the advanced techniques of you what you can use to make better plugs, then you should here use this. Then you should watch their own tutorials from this YouTube button. So keep that in mind. Anyways, now I have this kind of object here, and I can add here something in center, and I'm gonna add here a. I'm gonna snap the cursor in the center, and then Shift plus A, I'm gonna add here a cylinder. So something like that, and then I will bevel here a little bit. Control plus B, and let's use here width, and something like that. So what this is supposed to be, I think this is some sort of a light source or whatever. Something you might have in your hard surface object. So that's the idea of this, and then let's select all of those, Alt plus left click here, select those corners, and I'm gonna bevel also those slightly so it doesn't look so bad. And let's use here this present method so we don't overlap any edges. Okay, I think that's good. I think that's my plug now ready. So what I need to do now is to mark all of the sharp edges. So what can I do? I need to first select all of the sharp edges. So we can use here this select, and then select a sharp. select sharp edges like this, and it will select automatically for us everything that is more than 30 degrees angle. So this one, and that hidden one here. So Ctrl plus E, and then mark sharp. And also we need to select this ring here and mark it to be a smart sharp also. So Ctrl plus E, and then mark sharp also for that. And then we can set this as smooth, so right click and set smooth. And the other thing which we need to do is to go here to the object data properties and use auto smooth, because it looks better with that. Okay, so this is my plug now. Maybe I can move this one a little bit upwards. Okay, and then what I am going to do next is to open the mesh machine menu. Y, and then here plug utilities, and then create plug, and that will create for us this new handle object. So it's this one, so you can move now the plug with moving this. And what we are going to do next is to test this plug if it works or not. So we need to have a test object, and for me it's going to be a cube. So C plus A, mesh, and then cube. And I'm gonna bevel here this one corner, because I think I would like to have curved surface also here to be tested. So I select this edge and Ctrl plus B. Let's bevel this little bit. Something like that. And then let's B the box select this area, all of these things here, and C plus D to duplicate those. And now we need the snapping feature of Blender to make sure that it's aligned perfectly with this our object. So activate the snapping here, and then select face, and then snap with center, and then align rotation to target. And that's it. Now if you press G, it's aligned to the target object. You can scale it a little bit smaller if it feels like that it's too big. And I'm gonna select now those both, so that I can duplicate it. C plus D, and let's move the duplicated version here. Like that. Okay, now this is good. So select the handle object and then the target object with shift, and then Y to open mesh machine, and then plug. And that's it. Now you can edit those settings if you feel like that something is off. So you can adjust these settings. But I think that's actually working just fine, so I do the same here for the flat surface. So just like before, just select both and then plug. And that's it, it seems to be working. The plugging feature is working perfectly in my opinion, so I'm happy with this. Now, because it seems like that the plug is working, I can now add it to the library. So I select this handle object, and then I press Y, and then here plug utilities, and add plug to library. Like this, and I'm gonna add it to this my Mr. Sorpass plugs. Like that, and let's rename it. I don't know. This is just some. And let's press OK, and now Blender is doing the work to do everything that is needed to make it to work. Okay, so now I should be able to add those plugs I created with just here. Now after I did that, it should be the case that here in the mesh machine plug libraries there should be the Mr. Sorpass plugs, and then, but it seems that it's not the case. I don't know what happened to my plug. So I guess I'm gonna start Blender again and see if it's updated like that. So let's maybe save this project, and then let's reopen Blender to see if it's working now. Alright, so I'm gonna open the same project, and then let's try again. So I don't know what mesh machine did with this feature. It's not here. It was hiding my Mr. Sorpass plugs and the other group also, which I also had there. So it's a little bug, and I don't know what to do to fix that. Oh, okay, if I press Y, I have it here, but if I right click and then go measurement. Okay, wait a second. I don't know what's going on here. But now it seems to be here. It's good that I recorded this. So here is my Mr. Sorpa's plugs and I can open this one. And it's here. Okay, so now it seems to be working. I think it's somehow related to this Y shortcut. This is probably actually a different menu, but it's having the same items probably. And this Y menu, it was updating the right click menu. I don't know. That's just my very stupid idea of how I think it could work, but I don't know for real. But I think this Y menu is at least the menu you should be using, because it seems to be working better and it updated that right click menu. So yeah, keep that in mind. Y menu works better than the right click. And now I can add this my plug here, and let's add it here and test if it's still working. So select the handle and shift select the object and then Y and then plug. And as you can see, it's still working. So that's mesh meshing, and I am not going to go any deeper with this add-on. I know there are more features than that, but I think this already is quite long video and the advanced techniques already are in the documentation of this add-on. So that's why I think it's good idea to stop here. I think I did what I promised. I reviewed this add-on again. Now, I said this before, but I'm going to say it again. Mesh Machine is a very good Blender add-on that is adding into Blender some completely new ways to edit your objects. That's why I think I'm going to give to this add-on 4 stars out of 5. Thanks for watching. I am Mr. Sorpa and God bless.